Hello everyone. Yes class, our previous chapter, that is chapter number 1, nutrition in plants, is over. It's complete. Now let's move towards our chapter number 2, that is nutrition in animals. In this chapter we will study about the ever rising category of heterotrophic mode of nutrition, which I have told you many times that we will study in chapter number 2. That is holozoic mode of nutrition. Clear everyone? Before going deep into the holozoic mode of nutrition, we have to tell you one thing, that plants are following what? Plants are following heterotrophic mode of nutrition. They are not preparing their food by themselves. It means they are depend on others. The way of their dependency is changing the mode of nutrition also. Like mosquitoes are not following the holozoic mode of nutrition. They are sucking the blood from our body. Similarly, lice are not following holozoic mode of nutrition. Similarly, many examples are there, like butterflies. Butterflies are sucking the nectar from the flowers. They are not eating the flowers at all. Clear? The way of taking the nutrition from others is categorizing them into the subcategory. They are categorizing them into the subcategories of heterotrophic mode of nutrition. See, although they all are depend on others, that's why they are included in the category, in this category, but they are subcategorized according to how they are taking the nutrition. Now let's begin with the different animals feed on different food items. See, herbivores eat plants only, carnivores eat animals only, omnivores eat both plants and animals, scavengers feed on dead animals. Just think about the examples of all these categories. Herbivores, deer, cow are the herbivores, buffaloes. Similarly, carnivores are lion, tiger, fox. Clear? Omnivores, human beings, dogs are omnivores, cats, omnivore. Scavengers feed on dead animals, jackals, vultures, etc. These all are the examples. Think about some more examples of this category by your own, okay? Now, parasitic mode of nutrition in animals. See, this is also a type of nutrition which is followed by animals also, as well as plants. As we have studied about parasites in plants, that insectivorous plants, etc. and etc. we have studied in our previous chapter. And now about this mode in animals. Some animals derive nutrition from the body of other animals. These are called as parasites, ecto and endoparasites. We have studied about these types in our previous chapter also. Ecto, the animals which are taking the nutrition from the outside of other animals, like mosquitoes are sucking blood from outside body. While the stomach worms, that are round worms, flat worms, Tenia solium, Fasciola hepatica, many more. You will study about them in your further classes, about the name of these parasites. But you have to understand this in this, you have to understand right now that these all are the few parasites are living inside our body that are known as endoparasites and are taking the nutrition from the inside. Clear everyone? Now let's begin with holozoic mode of nutrition. Holo means whole and zoon means animals. Whole animals. The animals which are eating whole food particles are known as holozoic mode of nutrition. Holozoic mode of nutrition. See, holozoic. Just think about yourself. When you feel hungry, what you have done? Your mother will serve food to you. And when food comes in front of you, what is your first reaction? You start taking the bites of the food inside your mouth and start eating that food. Clear? Have you ever tried to suck the food? Have you ever tried to get the energy by smelling the food? Is it possible for you? Are we able to take the energy from the food by sucking, by smelling, or by thinking about the food? No. Means our mode, our way of taking the nutrition is different from others. From butterfly, we are not sucking the nectar, we are the eating whole food. See students, mode of nutrition in which solid whole particle of food are taken in means inside the body. We are taking the bites of the food and keeping that bite in our mouth, and then we are getting the nutrition after following a particular way of eating the food, isn't it? See, holozoic mode of nutrition occur in following steps. The first, this is the 5-step process: ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, and egestion. Ingestion. See, well, just think about yourself first to understand the holozoic mode of nutrition. You will understand all these steps properly if you are considering yourself. See, ingestion. We are taking the bite and keeping that bite in our mouth. It means we are ingesting the food. Ingesting means taking in. Now food is entering in our mouth, isn't it? Now the digestion. When the food will breakdown of food takes place and the energy will start releasing. The process of eating the food is known as digestion. Now what is absorption? When we are eating the food and breaking it, then different nutrients are releasing from the food. See, carbohydrates, fats, proteins are releasing from the food. That is known as absorption. And when the whole energy, whole nutrients which is present in the food are coming out and are taken by the different organs to function on them. You will study about it later on when I will explain you the human digestive system. You will understand about absorption and assimilation properly over there. But the process of transporting the nutrients which are released from the food to different parts and get the energy from that food is known as assimilation. Clear now? Now egestion. Whatever the waste, whatever we eat, some waste will get released, and that waste we use to excrete out from our body through our excretory organ as an excretory product. That is known as egestion, means exit. Ingestion, entry of the food, and egestion means exit of the excretory products from our body. This is the 5-step process, okay? And we are following this way of getting the nutrition, okay? Not every animal, not all animals. Many are following this way, but not all. Clear? Now, the nutrition in amoeba. See, amoeba is a single cell organelle. See, like we are the human beings and we are the social animals, but we are made up of millions and billions of cells. Our body consists of thousands of cells, isn't it? But amoeba is an organism. It is also a living organism, but it is a single-celled organism. Means it can perform all its activities through the single cell, only one cell. That's why it is a unicellular organism. Okay, students. Now, do you know where we can find amoeba? It is a freshwater animal, freshwater organism. Sorry, animal, I'm saying. It's an organism. Freshwater organism. Okay, it can easily found in fresh water. Now, when amoeba, how amoeba is taking the nutrition? See, every living organism is eating food to get the energy. The way of eating is different. So amoeba is also following that way. So how amoeba is eating, although it is a unicellular, only one cell is there. See, amoeba comes in contact with its prey. It extends its pseudopodia and surrounds the organism, forming a cup-like structure. A cup-like structure forms a food vacuole in the cell. This process is known as phagocytosis. Are you able to understand this language? I think no. See, I will explain it to you diagrammatically. Wait, see, here I am going to show you the diagrammatic structure of nutrition followed by amoeba. See, these all are the structure of amoeba. This is amoeba. In your previous class, chapter number 6 class, you have studied about amoeba in the chapter movement and locomotion. Have you studied? To move, amoeba makes the pseudopodia. Do you know what is pseudopodia? The word pseudo. Pseudo means false, faked, jhuta. Clear? Dhoka. Pseudopodias means the extension. Amoeba is a unicellular organism. That's why amoeba is not having a definite shape, definite structure. It can change its structure. Clear? Now, it can perform these pseudopodias. This extension of its structure is the formation of pseudopodia. Now, when amoeba is floating in fresh water, what happens? Now, the amoeba is hungry. Okay? Now, this amoeba wants food. Here, amoeba founds its food. Now, what happens? Amoeba starts making the false feet. It is extended its pseudopodia. See, the pseudopodia is extending. In the second stage, amoeba is forming a cup-like structure surrounding the food, prey. Do you know prey? The food of the pseudopodia here. See, cup-like structure is forming by the pseudopodias. And now, this food will get entered in the body as these false feet are covering the food. And the food enter into the body in the form of vacuole. Vacuole, you can say bubbles. Okay? Now, the food is taking in. And now, when the food is eaten up by the amoeba, then that food will get digested. Now the waste will start releasing. Again, the waste will get deposited in the form of what? Again, the waste is get deposited in the form of what? In the form of vacuole. See, digestion takes place. And then what happens? The food is absorbed, digested by assimilation. During the assimilation, waste will get formed. And it is deposited in the form of vacuole. Now that vacuole is again released out from the body. That is known as ejection. See, this small unicellular organism is following the way of holozoic mode of nutrition. How? Ingestion, taking in food, pura khana andar le liya. And then digestion of that food, absorption and assimilation. I will explain about absorption and assimilation while teaching you about human digestive system properly. And then ejection, releasing out of waste from the body. 5-step process. Clear everyone? Now today, no homework, no classwork is there. See, your homework is to do key terms of chapter number 2 in your notebook properly. You have to do all the key terms. No need to ask it again and again that, ma'am, shall we do 2, 3, how many key terms? You have to do all the key terms. Clear everyone? Okay, thank you.